Today we're gonna do some mobile macro photography and we're gonna use this new lens from Case. It's called the Master Macro Lens and it is pretty big for being a smartphone lens, right? It comes with two different ways to attach it to your phone, either this clip or you can also use this clamp thing. I prefer the clip because it's much easier than to take off the lens and to reattach it whenever you need to. The lens build quality is great. It's made out of metal and it feels high quality. I'm gonna use it today with my iPhone 12 mini and I'm gonna use an app called Halide for taking photos. And the reason I use this app and not the standard camera app is a few things. First of all, you can lock the camera you use, so you always use the same camera. With the standard camera app, it tends to get confused and switch between the cameras, and then that will not work great when you have a lens attached. The Halide app also has lots of other good features. For example, you can use focus peaking to see what's in focus when you're doing manual focusing. And by the way, you can do manual focusing with this app, which you cannot do with the standard app. And yeah, I really love the Halide app for serious photography on your smartphone. And I guess there are similar apps for Android as well. Today I went out into the forest to try this lens out. One thing that can be a little bit tricky is to center the lens properly. Besides taking a test shot to see that the picture is sharp, I found it easiest to look on the backside because then you can actually see if the lens is properly centered or not. And make sure that the lens is properly centered and that you can take a sharp test photo before you go out doing photography. Otherwise your photos may end up like this and yeah, just blurry and unsharp. Speaking of sharpness, let's just get that out of the way. This lens is extremely sharp. I found it very good optically. And the only thing that will really limit you with this lens is the performance of your smartphone camera and your smartphone camera sensor. And any photos in this video that are blurry, like this one, that's actually because I did a mistake when taking the photo. It is not because the lens is unsharp. I found this lens to be very good optically. One thing that was a bit of a bummer for me with my current phone, the iPhone 12 mini, is that my phone does not have a telephoto lens. It only has a 28mm equivalent, that is the longest focal length, and that actually means that I am quite limited in terms of magnification. Because with a lens like this, the Case lens, which is basically just a big magnifying glass, it will give you a lot more magnification the longer the focal length of your smartphone camera lens. So if I would have had a telephoto lens on my smartphone, which most new smartphones today have, I would have gotten a lot more magnification. Still though, with a macro mode on the Halide app, it can kind of digitally simulate a bit more magnification, and that worked pretty okay. But that is a word of warning. If you don't have a telephoto lens already on your smartphone, you will not get very close with the Case macro lens if you, for example, want to shoot insects. The price of the Case Master Macro Lens seems to be around $70 to $80, and I think that's a good value for money. Most similar macro lenses for smartphones cost a little bit more. By the way, this is how big a fly is if you don't have a telephoto lens, and this is a fly with the macro mode activated in the Halide app, which will take you a little bit closer. It was fun trying this lens and the lens itself performed beautifully, but I get reminded again, this is my second time shooting macro on a smartphone, that macro on a smartphone is not for me. I find it too cumbersome. It is very hard to adjust the settings on the fly on your smartphone camera. It is very low resolution and low dynamic range with a smartphone camera, and ergonomically it is pretty bad. And I mean, this lens is pretty big, so you might as well just have a small Micro Four Thirds camera with a dedicated macro lens if you want to go out taking macro photos. For me, I have a little bit of a hard time seeing the point with using a smartphone for macro photography, unless it is because you cannot afford a separate camera and macro lens and you want to do this very, very cheaply, then this might possibly be a good option. But if you already have a camera, you can very cheaply get into macro photography by reversing some old lens or using extension tubes. So I don't really find it that much about price, possibly about mobility. Of course, you can very easily bring this lens with you and just pop it on when you want to take a macro photo, but yeah, I don't know, this is not something for me, and I don't think I will do much more macro photography with smartphone in the future. I will stick to my digital cameras. But I will tell you that I have seen some really masterful phone macro photographers, especially in India. Some people are really talented and can take very nice photos with just a phone and a macro lens on a phone, so it is definitely possible. It's just not my cup of tea. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you soon again in another one. Bye bye.